Well, as you know, one of the top 2020 races in Montana this year will be the U.S. Senate contest between Republican incumbent Senator Steve Daines and Democratic Governor Steve Bullock. But what you may not know is that both men face opposition in their respective party primaries. MTN's Mike Dennison has more.
Before Governor Bullock got into the Senate race on the last possible day in March, three Democrats had already filed as candidates. Two of them then withdrew, and Michael Knowles of Bozeman suspended his campaign, although he still appears on the Democratic primary ballot. But energy engineer and U.S. Navy veteran John Muse is still running and says Democratic voters should consider him. He says his background and his vocal support of things like progressive taxation of the wealthy and multinational corporations and clean energy development make him an ideal challenger to Daines.
In today's era, we have some of the biggest challenges that this country has ever faced. But we need to vote intelligently and we need to vote courageously. Otherwise, we shouldn't take any of it for granted.
Senator Daines has two competitors in the Republican primary, including John Driscoll, who last ran as a Democrat in 2008 for Congress. Driscoll's campaign has consisted of a 56-county tour during which he posted Ace of Hearts signs that honor local acts of courage. Daines' other opponent is Stevensville hardware store manager Dan Larson, who supports a universal basic income payment of $1,000 a month for every citizen. Larson says the payment would replace other safety net programs and end up saving the government money and reduce human service bureaucracy. He also says Daines has supported and enabled the extremist tendencies of President Trump that are hurting the Republican Party. Larson says he offers an independent voice, not unlike, he says, another lesser-known Senate candidate.
So when we talk about the battle of two Steves, yeah. What I think of it is like this. If you looked at me running against like John Muse, I think that would be a better ballot. Better ballot in Montana. I think it would be a fresh perspective.
So if you're not down for the battle of the Steves in Montana's U.S. Senate race, you do have a choice. But I think we know who the winners will be after we count the primary votes on June 2nd. In Helena, Mike Dennison, MTN News.
Ballots for the all-male primary election were sent to all registered voters this week and are due back by June 2nd.